Hello and welcome to
the Punk.
What's up, Punk?
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 We take a look at the myriad subgenres underneath the umbrella of punk. Today we'll be taking a look at Cattlepunk. Get along, punks. First things out of the way, yeah, this one wasn't on the schedule. The schedule is arbitrary and controlled by my whim. The skirt shoot came out of nowhere and got me wanting to cover this one. And the randomizer, as always, has not been kind. Not to worry, we'll be getting back on schedule next time. Probably. Second order of business, if you're here for Cowpunk, which is his own lyrical thing combining country and punk music, sorry Haas, wrong video, it's on the list, and we'll be getting to it eventually. Now, what is Cattlepunk? Cattlepunk is the ultimate version of the Old West, with a big emphasis on science fiction and fantasy elements. It's a pretty sketchy genre. Ah, the Old West, where men were men and women still level a shotgun at me if I finish that statement. And indigenous people were getting their asses handed to them. A violent, bloody age where the government was just a word, an entire continent away. Yeah, pretty exciting for a punk genre. I kid, even if the Old West wasn't as romanticized as it is in pop culture.
We live in a terrible place and time. The American West is a disgusting, awful, dirty, dangerous place. Look around you. Everything out here that's not you wants to kill you.
Cowboys are awesome, and everyone wants to be Bass Reeves. The Western was one of the most popular film genres from the advent of film through the 60s. Science fiction is at least as awesome, so let's spit in the eye of Clint Eastwood and Frankenstein these together.
Hey, Butch! Don't you know Westerns are dead?
Speaking of dead.
This one is definitely a progenitor of desert punk. The big difference is that desert punk is about reclaiming the Old West pioneer spirit. At the end of the world or on another planet, this time around, we're just smack dab in the Old West. Cowpunk reshapes the universe of the Old West, making it, in some cases, basically Western steampunk. Also time travel.
Shoot, I want to be one of them fancy ray guns.
Ain't dependable. They jam.
The Western and the punk offering more sensational and subtle renderings. Some people peg Cowboy Bebop as cowpunk. I don't. Cowboy Bebop is its own bohemian thing that I'll never peg down to just one genre. At least how I feel about it. Let's get into that nitty and very gritty. Technology. We are all over the place on this one, but let's break it down. First of all, the basics are still intact. The horse, the gun, the steam engine are all here and period accurate. After that, it all goes off the rails. Steampunked. Sometimes derogatorily, you could call cattlepunk Western steampunk. And it's not very surprising, despite how some other punks take umbrage with it. Basically, the crazy-ass inventors and scientists that were doing their thing in England in the Old West. The Victorian Age was going on around the same time, and that's a cornerstone of steampunk. Just add gold fever, baby. Great example is Daisy Cutter, The Last Train. A short mini in the West about an ex-train robber doing a penetration test on the most secure train ever. Protected by the steampunk equivalent of the Terminator. It goes way south for all involved. The most known example, if you run in the bad movie circles I do, the movie that stopped Will Smith's blockbuster streak, Kevin Smith's Legend, that once bounced around Hollywood, and the movie that has a far, far superior music video, Wild Wild West, with that damn spider, and the various gadgets that Artemis Gordon makes, and however they kept Loveless alive. BTW, if you want to see the same thing but fun and fewer cross-dressing jokes, may I direct you to the man, the myth, the chin, Bruce Campbell's Briscoe County Jr.
You lose.
Aliens. How did those techno throwbacks construct the pyramids? Other than the obvious.
How did they move such massive pieces of stone without the aid of modern technology?
They had massive whips, Rimmer. Massive, massive whips.
Yep, Cattlepunk plays around a lot with the ancient aliens thing, but it's rarely benevolent. Basically, aliens visit Earth multiple times in history, just people either don't capture proof, keep notes, or you know.
Nope.
For example, being Iron West. Basically the most Cattlepunk thing ever. It has a Sasquatch and a Loch Ness monster fighting alien robots. And robots come together as a giant mech. God, I love these videos. Basically, robot colonizers pull the war of the world and launch capsules to Earth, sleeping underground till they are disturbed, and all hell breaks loose. The most well-known example being the movie Cowboys and Aliens, where aliens come to Earth to mine gold, but didn't count on America! Fuck yeah. Daniel Craig getting an arm buster plus some plot amnesia before losing both for his troubles. Future Shock. There's a punk genre about cowboys. Freaking cowboys. It's called Cowpunk. I can't wait to research that. It's probably insane. It has dino mounts. God bless you, 2000 AD. Besides World War II, because...
Anywhere in particular?
Well, let's see. You've got a time machine. I've got a gun. What the hell? Let's kill Hitler.
The Old West has got to be the second most time traveled location. Despite, well...
Try me. You want a kiss?
Oh, so much more germier than I pictured.
Gross. And the third being dinosaur time. So, why don't we just, like, mash a couple of these together? Fair example being, obviously, flesh. With the discovery of time travel, future man can travel back to the age of the great dinosaurs, which he kills for their flesh. You invented time travel because you don't like impossible meat. I think it has too much sodium too, but I think we kind of missed a step here, guys. While this one skirts the line on Cattlepunk being, you know, not the Old West, you know, except it has cattle drives and the closed and difference being, you know, they're triceratops now, you know, cows, which, you know, you can make the argument that triceratops is just a very big armored cow, which I think was in Jurassic Park. It's basically Old West, just, you know, in the time of the dinosaurs. Are we splitting hairs? Probably. Is it a fun time? Yes. But yeah, future tech landing in the hands of cowboys. It's a thing. What isn't splitting hairs is the perennial Cattlepunk. He's done it all, seen all of it, from steampunk future tech to normal cowboy antics. Jonah Hex.
Cut him down!
If you want the baseline for a Cattlepunk character, it's Hex. As the man said,
I've had an interesting life.
Love him or hate him, hand the man a six shooter or a laser gun, as long as being pointed at the enemy's gone. Aesthetic. Not going into clothing or architecture this time around, instead going to plug another one of my videos, Desertpunk, if you want the skinny on that. This is going to be more about the character, setting, and motivation of a cowpunk story. Now, I alluded to this in the intro, but this one is under some scrutiny in the punk community, as they don't see the punk in it all. That, as I said in my 100 sub video, is just using punk as a suffix to sound cool. Or just how it's kind of thrown on the cowboyish work that's not easily defined to a genre. I can see why they think that, and it's pretty valid. But I think they're coming from a false premise, because, well, it was my false premise. See, what we think of as cowboy movies or Old West tales, now we mostly think of stuff like this. Yeah, cowboy movies, which is, let's be real here, is where most of the popular consciousness on cowboys comes from, wasn't like this before the 60s. The 60s was a reclaiming of the dirty, dangerous, and morally gray that the time actually had than the pre-60s. Cowboy movies then were more like modern-day morality tales, and the heroes and villains were simplistic and easy to identify. It's where we got the old saying, black hats and white hats. Good guys wear white hats, bad guys wear black hats. It's why I call Hex the perennial Cattlepunk. He's a soldier from the South in the Confederate War, basically raised by a First Nation tribe, and despite doing the right thing and being an honorable man, Well, he gets that face for his troubles. In the pre-60s cowboy story, no way would Hex be the hero. Same for Miss Daisy Cutter, or Prentice Struck from Iron West, who is just straight up a coward. It's one of the reasons I love that one so much. He tries for most of the story to just peace out till he just can't anymore. That's the punk in all of this, that people are not a binary choice, good or evil, despite how oldest genres would say. The trappings help with that. They are the extraordinary situation suited to those that think outside the proverbial box. Where did Cattlepunk start? That's a hard one. Adding sci-fi elements to a cowboy tale is not a new concept. Earliest one I can think of would probably be The Beast of Hollow Mountain. Cattlepunk in the literary world dates back to the 1890s from dime store novel character Frank Reed, and his many stories of futuristic westerns. Also the spy western of the Wild West show that had a bit of a steampunk bent to it. However, I can tell you where the name cowpunk started, and that I hate them. Knights of the Dinner Table, aka that thing you read to discourage from being a GM. Knights of the Dinner Table is a comic, and when I use the term comic, I use that in the most barest definition possible. Newspaper style with little to no change in the panels, about an RPG campaign of BA and his players running the Boot Hills RPG. In the comic, the game is called Cattlepunk. Doesn't have any of the anachronistic tech or fantasy elements. My recommendations. Holy crap, I can actually do recommendations again. I think the last time I did this was like Cattlepunk. Barely. Iron West. Though I have spilled some of the plot points already, the art is great and there's some very fun dialogue. Honestly, it gets a gold seal of approval from me. Check it out. A town called Mercy. Doctor Who. The Doctor and the Pawns end up in Old West Town with electricity 10 years before that should, under siege from a cyborg gunslinger, because that's how the TARDIS rolls. It's a very straightforward story, which in the Moffat era is a breath of fresh air. Cards on the table, this isn't the best of modern Who. But it comes with a borged up alien and that's just cool. His chain gun reminds me of Proto's. I'm not immune to style points. Flesh. With the discovery of time travel, future man can travel back to the age of the great dinosaurs, which he kills for their flesh. You looked at a sound of thunder and was like, fuck it, I need meat.
With the discovery of time travel, future man can travel back to the age of the great dinosaurs, which he kills for their flesh.
The terrible truth behind dino nuggies.
With the discovery of time travel, future man can travel back to the age of the great dinosaurs, which he kills for their flesh.
With the absolute madhouse that is DC Comics, how is there no Black Lantern dinosaurs? Okay. Flesh is 2000 AD. It's insane, awesome, and violent. If that's your speed, check it out. We also have an honorable mention in the house, that being Evil West. At the time of writing this script, the game isn't out yet. However, I'm very excited to play, and I hope it's Cattlepunk. Seems like it is from the trailer, but until I actually get my hands on it, I can't say whether it is or isn't. How do I feel about Cattlepunk? I really, really want to like this one. I don't. It's not bad, and I had a lot of fun researching this one, but it's just too broad. Between aliens and future shock and steampunk, it's a lot. I'd actually be happier if it was just Western steampunk. I laid out why I don't have an issue with that, but everything else in the pod just makes it a really rich, eccentric chili I just don't have any interest in sampling. Sign out question. Is Westworld Cattlepunk? No! People keep trying to convince me otherwise, but this isn't like when I was inexperienced and said Mad Max was Dieselpunk. It's the future on another planet. Cattlepunk is alternative West history.
No, I'm from Iowa. I only work in outer space.
Not Old West theme park. Westworld at its best is cyberpunk and at its worst a waste of time. Well, this has been What's Up Punks. Till next time, be electrifying, punks. Be what you want to be, even that's a cowboy. But keep on being a no-good, dirty punk. You know it, you love it, here's the spiel, let's do it. Hit subscribe to be my subscriber. Hit the bell so you know when I've actually posted stuff. Still no idea why those two things are separate now, but whatever. And of course, hit like to appease the algorithm gods. All fear and praise. On a list of whatever YouTubes, I am also probably not going to get any ad revenue for these videos, so if you would be so kind, check out that Patreon and the GoFundMe.
Links in the description.